Kia ora, I'm David Chaston with 90 at 9, brought to you by interest.co.nz. This will get everything you need to know in 90 seconds at 9 o'clock with news that the bond market is sending clear signals today that much higher inflation is here to stay. But first in the US, new home sales picked up more than expected in September and are now running at an annual rate of 800,000, which is 17% higher than the annual rate in August, but miles below the 971,000 rate of sales in September 2020. The US Conference Board measures of consumer confidence rose in October when analysts were expecting another lower result. But consumer expectations remain low, even if they think the present situation for them is actually quite good. And the Richmond Fed factory survey in the mid-Atlantic states came in much better in October than for September. It is yet another survey that features good new order levels, rising backlogs, and prices jumping to near extreme levels. The surveyed firms do expect that the pricing pressures to ease, but to levels that would have sent warning bells in an earlier time. And we should also note that the US five-year break-even inflation rate is now touching 3%, the first time it's done that since 2005. Essentially, it is signaling that the bond market is betting inflation is here to stay. It isn't going to be transitory. Similar signals are coming from European markets. In China, the next shoe dropped late yesterday in the Evergrande saga. Rival Modern Land failed to repay a $250 million bond due to unexpected liquidity issues, they say. Modern Land is based in Beijing, but listed on the Hong Kong Stock Exchange. Over the past week, the Chinese Central Bank has added $700 billion in short-term liquidity into their banking system, probably because of the property sector woes. In the metals world, we should note that the fast jump in the magnesium price is easing almost as quickly as it rose. Recovering Chinese smelter production is behind the improvement, although prices are not expected to return all the way back to prior levels. US Treasury 10-year yield opens today down 2 basis points at 1.62%, and the price of gold has fallen back today by $15, the $1,792 an ounce. And oil prices are up a dollar to just under $84.50 a barrel in the US, while the international Brent price is up less, now at $85.50 a barrel. And the Kiwi dollar opens today little changed at 71.6 US cents. Against the Australian dollar, we're a fraction softer at 95.5 Australian cents, and against the euro, we're a fraction firmer at 61.8 euro cents. That means our trade weighted index starts today at just on 75.1, but still well over the top of the 72 to 74 range of the past 11 months. We welcome your feedback on these issues. Leave a comment below or on our website. Kia ora, I'm David Chaston. That was 90 at 9, brought to you by interest.co.nz.